Continue with the review and benchmark of the Videocon A15. You can see I have opened the camera. I don't want to show you the camera quality. It's with flash. As you can see, it's got a flash, but it's kind of a torch kind of flash, not exactly a flash. It's not that good, but it does the work for a average person who is just got the phone. So I'm gonna show you without flash photo also. It just takes a second to click the pic. And I'm gonna show you there's a timer also, and also a front camera as you can see. And also got a pretty much a few options like white balance, scene mode, automatic night mode, and image adjustment like brightness and white balance and color effects and store location, picture size and picture qualities. It's in super fine at the moment, and face detection. So it's a good camera, but in average you can take 16 burst shots in a one click. You can see we are taking the 16 shots, and you can see the pics in the image viewer gallery. You can see 16 pics were taken. There's average quality, and in daylight it works much better. You can see the quality, it's not that good. The pin zoom is very very smooth, no lags at all. You can see that. I'll show you the gallery also. The gallery is good. Proximity sensors works really good. At this price, it is awesome. It is awesome. I'm going to show you some photos, like you can see the color production, reproduction quality is really awesome, and as you can see, it's really smooth. It's also fast also. There's a clock also, and we have also have the Wi-Fi running, so we are getting the temperature of Delhi. It's 30 degree also. It's 30 degree at the moment, and you can use it as a clock also, like this. And there's a shortcut to gallery and video player, like you can see this. You can resume playing the video that you were playing earlier. The speaker quality is really not bad, but it's good. It's clear and crisp sound. I'm going to show you another video. And I'm going to show you, this is the MPC player, MX player also installed in this. And we want to show you, these are the Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, data connection and stuff, shortcuts to like brightness, timeout, auto rotation, Bluetooth airplane mode, and this is the memory booster we have installed, so we can boost the memory when it's getting low. As you can see, 31 MB is free at the moment, and 22 to 400 and 204 memory, 204 MB is used at the moment. You can do the quick boost in a second and it will, it has memory recovered as 37.36 MB and boost type is quick. You can also use task killer and kill selected in just a single click. As you can see, so fast. I'm just amazed to see a cell phone at this price running that fast. And also got a Play Store. You can install a game in a second using Wi-Fi. As it also have a 2.75G edge, but it's not as fast as Wi-Fi at the moment because we are not having 3G in this phone. So I'm gonna show you the browser also. You can see it's opening pretty fast in a second. Touch is so good. It's just a single click in a minute and it's it opens the, you see the pinch and zoom is really awesome. And it's got a camcorder, pre-installed camcorder, file manager, FM radio also is available, and maps, Google Maps. I'm going to show Nina Mark II score also that we missed earlier in the earlier video. It's 29.7 frames per second. Best is 29.7 frames per second. It's not that bad, but it's a better device. It's the best we can get in this price at the moment. You can see it's 15 frames less than Galaxy S2. And music player, we can show you. The average music player. So that's all for today's show. And goodbye.